Hello guys, my name is Sayani and welcome to my channel. So this is my first ever video on YouTube. I was planning to do YouTube from a very long time, but I am a shy person in general and I was so nervous. I didn't have the guts, but I stopped thinking and here I am. In this video, I am going to share with you guys 4 different room decor DIYs which you can make very easily and also only using coloring papers, scissor and glue. And I'm not going to talk too much and let's jump right into the video. So for this DIY, firstly we are gonna need some paper. I used the yellow one and I wanted a small paper pineapple, so I had to cut them into small pieces. You can cut them any size you want. Then you have to fold it and draw a half pineapple shape just like this and cut it out. Now do the same with the rest of the papers. Now take the half pineapple shaped papers and fold it twice, just like so. You have to do this with every piece of paper. Now take one and apply glue just where I marked. As example, there is 4 parts and I am applying the glue in the even part of the inside and odd part of the outside. Now keep doing this process with each and every piece of paper. Fold it twice. Apply glue, just like so. Now let it completely dry and after that just join the ending. Let it dry and your paper pineapple is ready. Now for the leaves, I am going to cut the green color paper into half leaf shape. Firstly, I am going to fold the paper and draw a half leaf shape. Now I'm gonna roughly cut it out and you don't have to be perfect, like you don't have to cut it perfectly. Now apply glue in the middle part of the inside and upper and lower part of the outside. Now do the same with every piece of paper. Let it completely dry and open it gently and apply glue in the ending. Now take the lid part and stick it above the pineapple. Let it dry and voila! Have a cute paper pineapple. You can keep it on your desk, use it as a room decor or anything you want. It looks super cute and super affordable. In this DIY, we are going to start with some paper straps which I have already cut. You don't need the exact same colors. You can use any color you like. I have the design which I have found on Pinterest. I am not going to do the exact same design. This is just for an idea. Now I'm going to start rolling the paper strap just like so and sticking the edges. Now for this shape, I am just rolling the strap but also pressing one side so that this corner becomes edgy. Now that you have a basic idea, so you can make any design you want. So be creative. After that, I am taking a white art paper strap for borders. Again, you can use any color you like. And I am sticking them on the borders. For the borders, I wanted to use black chart papers, but I didn't have one, so yeah. The whole DIY is all about rolling and rolling. It's that simple. You can see the shape is not exactly what I planned, but it was looking cool, so I didn't change anything. Now if you want the exact same oval shape, you can obviously use cardboards instead of art papers for the borders. And finally, we are done. You can hang them on your walls and yeah. For paper table lamp, I took an art paper. We have to roll the paper and stick the edges. So I am marking 1.5 cm from both the sides according to the paper size. We are going to draw in between those lines. Here I am making a sketch of dragonfly and some flowers. You can obviously draw whatever you want. Now we have to cut those blank spaces just like I am showing here with the help of a cutter. And for the small holes, I am using a safety pin. For the shadow effect, I am painting the lines with a black paint. Now for the thin lines, you can obviously use a marker if you are not comfortable with painting. Now I am taking a butter paper and stick it on the paper. Now roll the paper and stick the edges. Take a string light or fairy lights or any kind of small bulbs and keep it inside the lamp and you are done. Look how pretty it looks. First of all we need is some paper straps. I have cut them into 22 by 6.1 cm. Then roll these papers with the help of a stick and stick the edges. Make this as many as you want your paper stand to be big. For the base of the stand, take a cardboard and cut it out into a shape of a hexagon. Then for covering it, take a paper and draw a bigger hexagon, cut it out, also cut the corners, then stick it with the cardboard. Now take the rolled papers and stick them on top of each and every corner of the base and one extra on one corner. Then cover the upper part of the base with a paper. Here comes the main part. Bend the extra one over the right next to it and take it to the next corner. Keep doing this process, just like I am showing here. Just follow this process, it's too easy. It might be looking a little bit confusing and tough, but trust me, it's not. When one has come to its end, take another one and join it. Then again, keep repeating this process. I think it will be much easier to understand what to do by seeing what I am doing here. After doing it 2 to 3 times, it will become much easier. In the end, stick the edges like this. And if there is any extra, cut them and stick them. And the final result is right in front of you guys. You can see how beautiful it looks. That's it for today's video, guys. I hope my first impression and my first attempt was good enough to watch my upcoming videos. Also, please subscribe to my channel. It means a lot to me. And if you guys like this video, then please give it a thumbs up. Comment down below, like, share, subscribe. You already know, right? So, yeah. See you on my next video. Bye.